Hey guys, this is Martin again from Surge Electronics, and today I'm going to talk to you about the Madrix software and our DMX LED strip and how easy it is to set up the Madrix. And this could be applied to pretty much any Madrix application or setup. But in this case, we're going to be using a little screen that I made out of our DMX strip, and let's see how it goes. So first of all, you open up your Madrix and it should just look like this. It's plain, it doesn't really have much going on. So what you want to do first off is figure out how many pixels you have on your particular setup. Here we have a screen configuration setup, and we have 10 pixels going on our x-axis, and we have 7 pixels going on our y-axis. Now that we know that, and we know what y is and what x is, then we could take that information and input it on the Madrix. So we want to go here where it says preferences, which is here on the top. We go to matrix generator. And once we're there, this matrix generator window will open. And make sure your protocol is set to DMX, and also your product should be the exclamation generic RGB light 1 pixel. Usually it's there by default, but if it's not, make sure you select that. And then rotation should be set to original. And here's the important part. It says count X, Y, Z. And by default, it's going to be set to like 50, 51, or, you know, whatever the default may be on the particular version of the software you have. But here, your X, we said that it had been 10. So you want to set 10 there. And then your Y, you want to set that to 7. And your Z, you can leave it at 1, it's not going to affect anything. Now, the next part is the addressing, which is the start corner. Start corner, here we have our DMX coming in from this XLR that's connected from the strip to the interface. And the interface is connected through USB to the computer. And make sure that if you're starting up on the top left corner, that's what you're going to put there. So right here, we already have selected top left. Next thing is the main orientation. That means how the strips are laid out. If they're laid out in a horizontal manner or in a vertical manner. Here we have them going vertical, and if you notice, they're all bridged in a vertical manner. So we're gonna change this here to vertical, and then right here you'll notice it says snake mode, and it'll say. You could select that, or you could select with fixture rotation. We actually have it in snake mode. If you notice, it kind of snakes through with all these bridges on there. So we're going to set yes. We're going to select snake mode. So if you'll notice, you'll have this little thing here on the side that looks pretty much like our screen. The Z order, that's just not really applicable here because we don't have anything going on Z. So you can leave that like that. It's not going to affect anything. Make sure your DMX start channel is 1 and your DMX start universe is 1 because that's what we're doing. It's a simple thing. So we click apply and we'll click OK. Now you'll see here your visualizer has actually changed to something that looks more like our screen. So now we could test it. We'll do a simple color test. We'll just put the value of red, and you'll see that it just turns red, and that's great. But now, if we actually add a more complicated type of a figure, let's go to the graph, okay? And whatever you see here on the screen on your computer should be happening on your DMX LED strip setup or whatever type of setup you have. But you know, that's pretty much what it's doing now. They're both following the same thing. And here on Madrix, you could change a lot of stuff. You could change the height of what the effect's gonna look like. You could change the speed. You can make it go really fast. You can make it really slow. You could even stop it completely. So there's a bunch of stuff you could do. It comes with a bunch of preset effects, which they're all editable. So, you know, if you could do like a color scroll, you know, you could add your own colors to it. You could do all sorts of stuff. So remember, make sure your X and Y axes are set correctly. Make sure your pattern, which the way they're connected, is set up correctly. And also make sure that you have power, everything connected right. Remember, it's really simple. You got your DMX cable going out, and your USB connected to the computer, open up the program, and that's pretty much all there is to it. So if you guys have any questions, any comments, concerns, anything like that, don't forget to drop us a comment. Also, don't forget to check out our website, and don't forget to subscribe. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And like I said, if there's anything else we could do for you, let us know. Thanks for watching.